Call this next story the great container crisis of 2020 and 2021. The cost for those shipping containers, you know, those big metal boxes you see everywhere? Well, they are going through the roof. In fact, from China to a West Coast port like LA or Long Beach, prices have more than doubled. And close to it, from China to the East Coast. Now, this is actually causing a huge problem for U.S. companies looking to sell their goods either to Asia or other parts of the world, because it's now so lucrative for shipping companies and leasing firms who control the boxes that they'd rather send the cargo containers back to China empty rather than them go somewhere inside the United States, Indiana, Oklahoma, wherever, to pick up food or other exports. In fact, this is becoming such an issue for U.S. trade that the government is getting involved. And recently, the Federal Maritime Commission has started asking questions about what exactly is happening and how to fix it. Carl Bensel is a commissioner at the Federal Maritime Commission, and he joins us now, one of the authors or the author of that letter that was sent to some of the shipping companies. All right, Carl, it's a little bit of a confusing story for people that are not involved in the world of global trade or shipping. So in sort of, you know, seamen's or layman's terms, what exactly is happening to cause this massive price spike in the container business?
Brian, thanks. It's nice to talk. We've had a big challenge with COVID-19 going from in February, March, a situation where the imports in the United States of containerized imports were down 20 to 30% until to a situation in May or June when we increased by 20 or 30%, sort of a complete reversal as we imported a lot of PPE. We imported e-commerce, home improvement stuff as the population adjusted to living at home. We really have were taken by surprise, I think, in that early summer timeframe. We didn't have enough equipment. We didn't have retailers were building up cargo and they were not getting trucking back to the ports in time to get cargo processed through the ports. And ultimately, we ran into a situation where we are right now, where we basically have gone from zero ships outside of the port of LA Long Beach to 41 waiting 1 or 2 weeks to be able to discharge cargo.
Carl, let me jump in. We've seen some of the helicopter shots. You know, go. It's amazing. If you're off the coast of LA, there's gigantic ships just sitting there that were not there a couple of months ago, 0 to 41 in a couple of weeks. You got empty containers. I guess what a couple people on Twitter and other people I've talked to have asked is, why would it be more profitable to send an empty container back to China or wherever than to put it into commission inside the United States to pick up soybeans or bourbon or whatever it might be?
It's a confluence of issues. Generally, the cargo that we get from China is high tech. It has greater value than, for instance, soybeans, perhaps not bourbon, but for the most part, U.S. exports are lower value agricultural commodities. And with rates going so high, the cargo, the shippers, the carriers have been trying to get containers back to Asia to take advantage of the rates that they're getting to ship from Asia to the United States.
And I've been working on this for a couple of days. I'll be traveling tomorrow about it. And I asked a dumb question. I said, why don't we just make more containers? They're pretty basic things, right? In fact, there used to be too many of them. Now there's not enough. Why is there also seemingly a slowdown in the manufacture of containers, Carl?
It's unclear. We're looking at it right now, but at the beginning of COVID, because all of this manufacture of containers takes place in China, which is an issue. I think we need to consider our reliance on this little metal container in terms of our trade and our objectives as a nation. But they stopped manufacturing them. They have been very slow on the uptake. On manufacturing containers at a point where they're manufacturing all sorts of other imports that are coming here. So I think we really need to take a look at what's going on and evaluate it. Yeah. We see now that the price for a container is 50% more than it was earlier this year. And we've seen reductions over the year of about 30% in terms of the manufacture of the containers that we use for shipping.
Which, Carl, we got to leave it there, but that makes no sense.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.